Everyone, welcome to this cohort for Creative Commons for Librarians. I'm Robert Gibson. I'm going to be your facilitator. Just wanted to do a quick introduction so you can get to know me a little bit better as we start this journey over the next 10 weeks or so. A little bit about me. I've been in higher education now for longer than I care to admit, mostly at traditional liberal arts universities. I've worked at a variety of institutions over the years. I was at the University of Colorado Denver for a while. I've been at private liberal arts colleges, parochial colleges. I've been at regional universities. My last stop was at a small university, a regional teachers college in Kansas. And now I'm currently actually working for campus of applied science and technology, an affiliate of Wichita State University in Wichita, Kansas. The Dean of Instructional Technology and Academic Support, and also the Director of Instructional Design for that particular school. I'm fairly new to this stop. I've only been here since October or so. I've sort of traditionally worked in four-year institutions, anything from, parochial through R1, but this is a little different journey for me, probably my last stop in my career, but I'm working now for a combined 2-year plus a technical college, which is a little different for me. It's fun. It's just different. I'm just not used to that, but I'm figuring things out here pretty quickly. But we do, in addition to the traditional gen ed courses and programs, we also have a lot of really interesting programs. We have culinary, advanced manufacturing, we call smart manufacturing, robotics, big aviation program here. A lot of different really interesting things, very cutting edge, work very closely with local manufacturing and industry in terms of partnerships. We also do some outside consulting with external companies which come into this area and develop their training and development programs. This is my second time facilitating a Creative Commons cohort. I did it again, it was about a year ago actually, almost a year exact. Was my first facilitation. I went through the program probably about 3 or 4 years ago. Always fun, always learn something new. Advance apologies if I stumble, it's not something you do every day. It's not a daily sort of deal. You are called to facilitate maybe once a year or so. So you have to kind of shake off some rust and kind of get back into the groove. So as I move along here, I'm sure I'll kind of get back into the rhythm of the program a little bit. But looking forward to meeting all of you over the next days and weeks, and actually months. This is about a 10-week program. It's intense, but you're going to learn a lot. I came out of the program just awash in great information, and I was able to apply immediately. And I'm sure some of you, like me, are probably parts of statewide task forces. I'm part of an open educational resource task force established by our governing agency for state higher education. And I serve on that committee. I'm what's called a train the trainer. So I train other people in the use of open educational resources, that sort of thing. It's kind of a statewide deal. And I'm sure a lot of you are on similar task forces or steering committees, that sort of thing. So the information you're going to learn in this program is immediately applicable to those sorts of committees and task forces, those types of things. So I think you're going to find immediate application. To the assignments, I just wanted to note that creativity is strongly encouraged. Don't think in box, think very creatively. I've had people submit assignments using everything from H5P, which is, timeline generators to, traditional slide decks, which are okay. I mean, that's acceptable. But you can certainly push the boundaries a bit. I've had people use claymation and all sorts of really interesting sorts of ways to approach and tackle the assignments. So think creatively. Think outside the box. You're not going to be penalized for that. I strongly encourage that. You've probably heard the old axiom, student voice and choice. I'm a big believer in that. So the more that you can exercise that choice and freedom to express the assignment and whatever means you think is best, by all means do that. As long as it meets the criterion for the rubric and includes all the various checkpoints and deliverables, then there's really there's no problem with that whatsoever at all. If you are also I'm a faculty member as well on the side. I teach in a graduate program, and I encourage my students. I'm sure if you're in a teaching or instructional capacity, I encourage my students to utilize Creative Commons licensing whenever possible. I actually give them a crash course of that. So if you're in a teaching capacity, hopefully you'll be able to utilize information from this program, such as the licensing schema, and be able to share that with your own students, and be able to promote the utilization of Creative Commons and open educational resources. By the way, in my courses, I never use textbooks anymore. I use OER for everything. I walk the walk, and I make sure that I always use OER. I'm sure you're the same way as well. So, anyway, it's great to meet you, and I'll be getting to know each of you in more detail throughout the program. I think I mentioned in my introductory email that I do like to do video-based responses, if possible. Not with my not with my face in the way, but just sort of a walk talk, record the screen while I'm giving some feedback. I think that's more effective. It adds a different dimension to the assignments than just traditional markup. So it takes me a little longer to do that, of course. So I appreciate your patience, but I hope that that's something that's going to be of value to you. So typically we'll send a link through Canvas to watch a short 5-minute recording of some feedback on each of the assignments. So anyway, enough of me. I look forward to working with you, and best of luck in the program.